Support for this episode of the PowerCast comes from Mark Bell's Slingshot. Check out the all-new website at howmuchyoubench.net. Bench heavy with no pain with Mark Bell's Slingshot. Apparel for strong people from our friends at 8manstrong.com. And bodybuilding.com. Bodybuilding.com is the world's number one fitness website and supplement store. Bodybuilding.com has free fitness plans for every fitness level. Visit bodybuilding.com today to become your best self. The title of this episode, number 169, is inspired by something that Mike said while we were recording about how his facts are often about half true. And I think that's true of the show in general as well. We talk about an often quoted study on the effectiveness of steroids on the untrained. We debate somewhat whether or not we told a bunch of inappropriate ethnic jokes at Bart Kwan's expense when he was on the show last year. We watch and comment on the live stream of USAPL Raw Nationals, and Mark rips into the politics of the IPF and USAPL. And we finish up with some NFL talk and a robot that does pushups and even sweats. Please like and share this video and enjoy number 169.
Leave, let's leave Smokey some eggplants.
I'll try to get him. All right, yeah.
What's the opposite of an eggplant?
Recorded live. I guess Super kind of the beach. Gym in West Sacramento, California.
There's like a clam this or something. I don't know why that's
Mark
not
Bell's PowerCast.
Let's make it popular.
Silent Mike, you know, and Jim like McDee. Like, here's like your host, Mark Bell.
That's a good question.
We're going to start with a contest and a request.
So. I love contests. Yeah. Is it a dick push-up contest? Cock push-up contest?
Dick measuring.
Oh,
if you guys are in
for some available.
We're out.
I already disqualified before you measured.
Yeah, whoops.
We got some awesome supplement package for you guys from bodybuilding.com. They got you guys covered. So BB.com is giving away 5-pound container of top-of-the-line protein,
Damn.
Protein bars, and pre-workout. That's right. All free shit, my friends. All you have to do is go to Mark Bell's PowerCast, tag 3 friends in there that you guys think need to listen to the podcast. Then you're also going to go to Little Smokey ST and leave eggplants over his latest... His latest picture, which is probably something stupid because he thinks he's funny on Instagram. So, at Little Smokey ST, we need eggplants and clamshells. Mark decided that he wants to make the clamshell popular because it is a missing part that we don't talk about.
Yeah,
And then 3
I
friends.
I think it'd be the opposite. It'd be the opposite of an eggplant.
Yeah, yeah, they can go together, obviously. Yeah. The birds and the bees. And then at Mark Bell's PowerCast on Instagram, tag 3 friends, and you'll automatically be entered to win some dope supplements, my friends.
So the clamshell is like the third
part. The grabbing the pussy, yeah.
The third part of the eggplant peach. Triumvirate.
Yeah, the trifecta.
Trifecta.
The God's trifecta.
I had everybody leave 8-man a banana one time. That worked pretty good.
Yeah, that's funny.
But eggplant, yeah, Smokey could use more vegetables, I think.
He definitely could use Why more not? Eggplant.
Mm-hmm.
Why not?
Back to my butthole. Yeah. I know that's been a topic.
As you drink a large coffee and eat protein popcorn.
Yeah, I know. That's going to really blow it out bad, isn't it?
This popcorn is probably... Popcorn in general is really good, but it makes you shit. I mean, there's a lot of fiber involved.
Gets stuck in your teeth forever. That's my my problem with popcorn. Unless it tastes like amazing, I won't
like
eat
this.
It. Yeah, this is really good because it's sweet and I'm fat. I like things that are sweet.
I'm fat.
Yeah.
I'm fat.
But, you know, you've heard me talk about my toilet bowl lid and you heard me talk about the detachable shower head.
Yes.
But I've been on to this new thing lately. I got the detachable shower head, right? Now picture this. I can take a photo for you guys if you'd really if you really like.
Yeah.
But I've been squirting shampoo on the detachable shower head and then aiming it up my crack. So it's like working like you're going to one of those car washes where you got the soap and the water going at the same time.
So is it before the water's even going, you just like squirt shampoo on the nozzle?
It's strategically nozzle? Like on the nozzle where the water's not shooting, and then I turn it upside down and I spray it in there.
That
it's
makes
amazing.
Sense. So what I'm picturing now is bartenders, how they pour soda,
mm-hmm.
and there's a button for different flavors.
Yeah.
But it all is squirted by water.
Yeah.
So what if we get some action like that on the rear end, right? So you can push the shampoo, you mm-hmm. can push the conditioner, because everyone's got some shit going
you
on
You should
back
be
there.
Able to spray some soap out of your goddamn
Smokey,
thing,
you're
right?
like, where'd he go? He's like the
Why
professional
can't it
with beards.
It? I mean, you know, butthole aside.
Yeah, yeah.
why can't it intertwine some soap and some water?
That's a good question.
I think it's a good move. Irritation, maybe?
Maybe your eyes.
Sensitive parts down there?
Oh,
sensitive brown eye?
Mm.
Question. I know it kind of makes me think of you know, back in the day.
I don't want to. I'm not sure if I want to.
Back in the day.
Back in the day, motels instead of putting the little bottles of shampoos and shit, they would have like a thing that they filled up, and it would have buttons in the shower, and you just like.
I think like fancy gyms have that.
Yeah.
No, it's like move. it's like in the wall kind of thing.
Yeah, it's stuck on the wall. Yeah. No, we stayed at a place earlier this year in Oregon that still had one. I thought I was time traveling for a minute.
I think those are cool. It makes sense. I mean, the little bottles maybe just more sanitary. Maybe, I don't know.
I want to bring up something else today. I had sex with my wife today. I figured I'm just going to bring it up every time that it happens. I'm going to bring it up. I think I do pretty good for myself.
Yeah.
Just memorializing it.
Yeah. Why not? Why not talk about it? No one ever talks about it.
People talk about celebrating small victories.
Yeah. No, this was very small. For her, it was. Yeah.
This is why you were late. I thought somebody was working on your kitchen.
Yeah. No.
You were working in your kitchen.
Yeah. Maybe. No, we are working on our kitchen. We've got some people in there doing some different shit to the cabinets and all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
So all kinds of crap's going on over at that house.
Construction.
Sex, construction, all kinds of things are going on all at the same time.
It's like the Village People.
We got some video cameras in that bitch too to record all the action.
The sex or the construction?
No, we just got security cameras put up, that's all.
Oh.
You can't hear anything in my house. Like if we're upstairs, you can't hear things.
Can you see it from your phone?
You could if you wanted to. There's like an app I think that we have, but
like
we haven't
shit like that.
We haven't messed with that part of it yet.
Oh,
we
Jim
have
has something like that, don't you? A doorbell?
I absolutely do. Yeah.
Yeah. There you
he
go.
Can see his house right now.
That's great.
We totally. Since we're just talking about random shit, we put my dog on Xanax, and so he's the best dog in the world, nicest dog in the world.
Xanax is life.
But he's like very frightened. And there's a difference though, like skittish.
When he gets frightened, does he like pee and stuff like that kind of stuff, or
so a
like
little
freaks,
bit
freaks out?
Yeah. So like I've been around dogs my whole life. So like skittish dogs, they get frightened and you're scared they're gonna bite you.
Yeah.
Like my dog literally runs for his fucking life. Like he would never hurt anybody. Like literally, you knock at the door, he'll bark, and then once he sees you, he runs for his life. It's not like he stays and kind of like feels it out. He's scared as shit.
That's me leaving my house today. My doorbell recorded.
That's pretty
it.
Cool.
Yeah.
It looks like a GoPro.
Yeah, cool. It pretty much that's what it is. Yeah,
yeah.
And so he's been on Xanax for like 2 days now, and he just kind of like just walks around the house. Like it literally looks like he's high. He also had surgery, so he could still just be fucked up from that. But he looks so high; it's so sad.
He's like Snoop Dogg.
He's like kind of. He just like walks like he's not sad. He's not happy. He's just like walking around everywhere. I was like, "What the fuck are you doing?"
You check under his collar, and he's got a weed card.
Yeah, maybe. I wonder if they give dog marijuana.
Yeah. Yeah, they can.
You have to check his room. He might be dabbling
growing.
In some other shit.
Growing.
Yeah, he might be
growing.
Well, you guys,
how
remember
much does he take? Like, does he take like a pill, or how do they administer?
It's not Xanax. It's like some other form. Mm-hmm. But when you Google it, Xanax pops up.
It's just something to calm him down.
Yeah,
basically.
But he's not like. It's weird because he's like, not that hyper.
Yeah.
He's just kind of like he's really scared of noises.
But this helps.
I don't know.
He's got social anxiety.
Because he's like so the opposite way now. Like it seems like it's not him. It's kind of like you think a human, you know? Like if Smokey came on all hopped up on shit, we're like, all right, well, Smokey's not being Smokey. And you're like, damn, like this isn't even my dog right now.
You guys remember when Cove had Radar?
And, yeah. And he was on Prescription Thugs.
And he was on drugs.
So Radar, I feel like obviously
cute dog.
That dog was in the gym, so it was a different vibe, but that dog wouldn't like stop barking and wouldn't stop like walking around in circles. Like my dog chills.
Right.
He's just like scared of things. He literally needs a therapist, I think.
Well, what happened with that dog, at least in my view, is that the minute that it went off the drugs, it got nasty.
Oh, really?
It was really a crabby ass dog. Yeah. He was like, dang.
That sucks.
Yeah, he stayed at my house some, and he would just fucking growl at you. I was like, what the fuck, you little shit?
Yeah.
Your dog is Ali, right?
Cassius.
Does he realize that there's nothing to fear but fear itself? Have you talked to him before?
I know. He's so scared. Yeah. And we've had him since a baby. Like sometimes when you adopt from a pound or you adopt somewhere.
You don't know what somebody did to the dog.
We had him since he was like an infant. And he's still all fucked up.
Just weird.
I've never had. Yeah,
that's so just a weird dude.
He needs to like meditate a little bit or something.
He does. He needs a therapist and meditation. Maybe pop.
What is Xanax? Is it for?
I think
is it for bipolar or?
It's a
benzodiazepine. It's a
sedative.
It's an anti-anxiety drug.
Yeah.
And so you don't know like what happens if there's loud noises now.
Maybe he looks like he's half asleep, like just walking around.
If there's a loud noise, he's just still
He heard the door and like barked. It's only been like a day, so yeah. It's hard to tell. Okay. You know, it's only been literally. He had like some kind of weird surgery. He ate grass and it got caught in his tonsils, so he was coughing for 3 hours straight.
Oh,
so he had like emergency surgery.
They're totally like little kids.
Yeah, and at the same time, there's $500, and at the same time, they're like yeah, maybe we should try the Xanax now. Like, all right, great. Like, he's already fucking high from your shit morphine. Might as well keep going.
Yeah,
I don't know. We'll try a week and see what happens.
Well,
so weird.
Hopefully he's not nasty when it comes off, if he comes off.
Yeah, hopefully a week, you know, he won't like get weird.
Now somebody's gonna rob your place and he's not gonna
care. He'll just be sleeping.
He won't give a shit.
At least he looks kind of mean.
Did it make him sleepy?
So I can't tell because he had surgery.
Oh, okay.
So like he's moping around. I don't know if that's from having surgery or if it's the new Xanax.
Is he on painkillers too?
He's on everything.
He's mixing.
He's got like antibiotics. Yeah, the doctor's like, oh yeah, he could take it all at once. Like, all right, here we go. I got a fucking Hollywood
gin and juice going. Or?
He's big. He's like 85 pounds.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so he's a big old guy.
How do you give a dog drugs?
Salami.
Oh, I've done it with peanut butter too. But
something like that. You hide it in there, you roll it up in some salami.
So it's literally just a pill?
Yeah.
Still?
And he'll fucking eat that salami so fast because they love that shit. Or peanut butter.
Yeah,
he won't even care. Even though some dogs, I feel like my girlfriend's dog will find that pill and like spit it out. It'll like unroll it and like eat the meat and
I've
spit
seen
out
that
the
happen too.
Sandy's dog is all fancy.
Yeah.
It's all highbrow. Yeah. Like, oh, I don't like this pill.
Yeah, stupid dog.
That's awesome.
Her dog's dumb though.
Yeah, I've seen that happen before. I've my dog's done that in the past, but normally I can get her with peanut butter.
I've never been on like Xanax or morphine. I can't even relate to my poor dog.
I'd love to be on all that shit.
Yeah, Xanax. Yeah, I was telling my mom like, man, like Xanax, some real shit. Like that's what people like Xanny bars. Like Lil Wayne, if you know Lil Wayne raps about it, you know it's some real shit.
Oh, well, it's got to be great.
The thing is, if you, I mean, from my perspective,
it's got to be a lot of fun.
Speaking purely theoretically here, if you're the kind of person that wakes up during the night and can't go back to sleep because your mind is running on whatever, it really helps.
Xanax. There you go, ladies and gentlemen.
Ativan, any of those benzos.
Xanax
but they're
wants
also
to sponsor this podcast.
They're also super addictive.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And then people overdo
it. And don't
it.
Mix them with anything because it's the same receptors as alcohol.
So. For the dog, on the dog bottle, it said if it mixed with alcohol, you can die. I was like, good thing I'm not giving my dog beer. Like, what the hell?
Yeah. It's bad news to do that,
What is that about?
I don't know. What else you got, Jim? I know Jim's got something you want to tell
us. I got two things. One of them was funny. For years now, there's been a commenter on YouTube called Steroids Are for Losers.
I love it. I'm into it.
And he's like bodybuilding videos, hours, a bunch of them, like been all over the stand videos for years or whatever. And sometimes I delete the stuff and if it's way too far out there or just won't fucking give up.
Right.
And other times I just sort of let it go. This today I got a message from him. This guy has been totally anonymous until a week or so ago. For years, probably the better part of 10 years commenting, he finally made a video talking directly to the
commenting
camera.
Commenting for a decade.
And
YouTube veteran.
So he sent me a message about...
This is a personal message?
Is a personal message on my YouTube channel.
I've heard of this study, and I think we've talked about it before.
I think we have, too, and I actually pulled it up. But basically, he's talking about how four groups in this study, and that the people who took testosterone but did not work out put on more muscle than the people who didn't take testosterone and worked out.
In untrained individuals, correct?
Normally, yeah. Normally,
I think it was in untrained individuals.
What I did not know before I saw this was the dosage. The dosage was 600 milligrams. I looked at, actually, he linked me to a study which was on one of these, sites. Yes. And then I went to the actual article, which is on the New England Journal of Medicine. It is called The Effects of Supraphysiological Doses of Testosterone on Muscle Size and Strength in Normal Men. This came from...
Is it a coincidence that it's the New 96. England Journal of Medicine and the New England Patriots are always so good and they have these steroid
Tom Brady.
Tests going? To do with it.
What's a TRT dose of testosterone?
Lower than that.
This is 600.
150 to 200.
A day?
A week.
And this is 600 a week?
600 a week.
So
I think your average male produces like, it's like 7 milligrams a day or something like that, isn't it?
Yeah, something like
testosterone.
That.
Testosterone, so very low.
Yeah, it's pretty low, and the issue is...
I think that's free testosterone, which is a little bit different than your actual injecting of whatever the hell it is.
Extra testosterone, and then there's...
androgynous.
So this is a good amount. This is maybe a bodybuilder dose?
It's not a bodybuilder dose, but it's a pretty significant dose. It's a hell of a lot more than TRT.
This is a great like first cycle dose for those of you that are writing this down at home. Somebody would take 600 milligrams of test and 600 milligrams of DECA or something like
that.
So
it's definitely a performance dose.
It is.
Absolutely.
It's not a TRT
dose. It's not chump changes. Yeah, it's not a nice amount.
So I don't know why anybody's surprised by this study. And I don't know why.
Well, that's right. So I don't know if it was, don't quote me, here goes all my random facts that I only know half of. But it might have been like Nazi Germany and like all this stuff. Like they made steroids.
Soldiers and stuff.
They made steroids to allow you to maintain, if not grow muscle after surgeries. Or I literally think steroids themselves were from World War II victims, if I'm not wrong. I think they tried to first use them on people that were in concentration camps because they were starved and they were down and they needed to gain weight.
You could be right about that.
I mean, once again, my facts are always 50%. Yeah. So don't quote me, and I'm not saying I'm a genius, but I've heard things like that. Mm-hmm. So then a study like this would make 100%.
Right.
If our goal is to put weight on someone.
And even despite whether your facts are 100% or not, they are used today for medical purposes, burn victims and other people that lose a lot of weight.
Right.
They've been used before.
Yeah, so it makes sense that if you just sit there, you'll gain more muscle than someone who, with this natural amount of testosterone, tries to work out. And obviously, the longevity of the thing matters. So, like, say they run the same study for 10 years, mm-hmm. the person who works out with no steroids will probably surpass them.
Yeah.
Right? Because there's diminishing returns don't work out on steroids.
So, take somebody that is untrained and measure their muscle mass, keep them untrained. They don't perform any exercise. Maybe they change their diet and have a healthier diet, and compare it to somebody who out of nowhere starts to exercise. There's going to be a huge difference. There'll be a huge change, right, in the person that did exercise and the person versus the person that didn't exercise. Anytime something's new that introduced, steroids are really a weird thing because they do give you a bump, but the bump, you know, it's not like it just keeps going on forever. And I think the message gets diluted sometimes when you see some of these guys, you know, hitting some of these weights all the time where you're like, how does the guys keep getting stronger? And you can only attribute it to like something superhuman because you like it's hard to comprehend.
Yeah,
but if you have a drug tested athlete such as Ray Williams and you have a non-tested athlete such as Eric Lillibridge who squatted 1,060 in training just a couple days ago and smashed it. Beautiful squat. When you see these guys getting stronger and stronger, it's hard not to attribute it to, maybe there's, you know, something else going on. And whether it's the guy who's getting tested or the guy who's not getting tested, you're just, that's what we're kind of faced with because we're like, fuck, man, I'm trying to get stronger too over here.
Yeah.
And it doesn't seem to matter what changes I'm trying to make. It's not easy.
It's got to be something I don't have my hands on.
Was Ray in the NFL? I know he played college football. Maybe we could look it up.
I think he's pretty young.
Ray? I mean, maybe not NFL. I think he's 30.
Oh, is he?
I think so. I might be wrong. I think he played...
A big boy, either way. He's a big kid.
I think he played high-level football. Mm-hmm. You know, well,
he squatted 1,000 in training, right?
Yeah. What I was going to get to is, like, genetics. You know, the thing that blows my mind is still how these people can progress so great, where, like, if Adrian Peterson wasn't playing football and he was lifting, like, maybe you'd understand it.
Yeah, how long ago was that clip, too, from up there? Where are you
2013? Going?
Yeah, it's not. Yeah, I mean, it's not that old. 2013, he busted out 905.
Yeah,
2 or 3 years, he's added 100 pounds on his squat.
Right, and when he's already so strong.
Yeah, that's a lot, man. That's
coaches junior college football.
I wonder when he competes. USAPL Nationals are going on right now. Him and Dennis Cornelius, and then my boy Andy Askow. All the fatties are going nuts.
So anyway, my point here was his sign off was Reuters are fakes. Stay natural, buddy. Like, here's
that's
the thing.
Do you think he's joking?
I don't think he's joking. I don't. What I don't get though is how anybody sees this study as a deterrent for anything at all.
Mm-hmm. it has.
In fact, it has exactly the opposite effect.
That particular study shows nothing negative.
Yeah.
It shows awesomeness. What,
yeah.
It's what, just like a politics, and I don't want to talk politics by
there's
any
the
means.
Guy right there. Mm-hmm.
That's great.
Where the negative side does come in, and it's a side that people don't want to talk about, is there's got to be some sort of end game of some sort.
Yeah.
Eventually, you know, myself included, any of these guys you see running around these trade shows that are big and jacked, there's going to be a time where they're no longer big and jacked. They're going to look a lot different as opposed to somebody who did it naturally their whole career, somebody who did it naturally their whole life. The natural guy is going to change too. And you're going to go, shit,
exactly.
Man, that guy really shrunk or whatever. But it's not going to be nearly as drastic. It's not going to be nearly as shocking. And you can hold on to some good muscle mass, you know, pretty late into your, you know, 60s and stuff like that. But who wants to be on steroids into, like, their 70s, you know? I don't know.
Everybody.
Yeah, everybody
in their 70s.
Yeah.
I guess all that matters, too, is, like, what steroids you're taking and doses, right?
Right.
Like, what you're saying is that maybe you don't totally get off them, but you down-regulate all of it.
Yeah.
What's just weird to me, though, is, like, Facebook's obviously the best example right now. People are going ape shit with whatever their political views are.
Right.
And one, I think people should understand that no one gives a fuck what your views are. You know, like, none of your friends on Facebook give a flying fuck.
Yeah, it seldom makes me think more of people.
No one, never. Even if they agree with you, often you think less. Right?
Yeah,
just
you're
like, all right, dude, why are you preaching?
Right.
But then people take that to everything, like whether it's abortion or it's guns or steroids. Buddy, like, that's cool. You don't like steroids?
Yeah.
And you can really not like powerlifting if you don't like steroids. Or you could not like Arnold if you don't like steroids. Like, I don't give a fuck.
Right.
But once you start to go preaching people, like, no one cares. It makes it, like, way less of everything.
Right. Right.
It solves zero.
So this leads me to my next topic. I don't know if you guys know that Bill O'Reilly's show did a On the Street segment that was supposed to be mimicking, like, some Comedy Central show like The Daily Show or whatever, where they were talking to Asian people and they were making Asian jokes, but they were doing it so badly that it was just pissing people off.
And this is on regular TV.
It was on
Comedy Central
cable.
Or something.
Well, it was on whatever he's on. Fox.
But a big
Fox.
Ass
yeah. And so that triggered a lot of people.
Yeah.
As you might understand. And you remember last year when we had Bart and Gio on the show? Well, it started then, and it's never really completely stopped, and it really blew up the other day, where people were saying that we were being racist toward Bart, and Bart was uncomfortable the whole time.
Which is how Bart got famous. Bart's, I believe, Chinese and Peruvian.
Okay.
And he got famous on the internet for doing a bad Thai accent.
Yeah, well, and also,
which is fucking, like, that's literally his first viral video.
Also, on top of that, him and his partner at JK Films, they made spoofs of the Asian culture, of his Asian culture, the way he was raised, and it turned out that so many people connected with them that they had no idea some of the things that they were sharing, which are things that most people wouldn't talk about. They found out a lot of other people had that in common, and they were like, holy fuck.
When you start to look at some stereotypes, like, I think one that they joke about a lot is Chinese moms being, like, strict and loud and abrupt.
Right.
Like, oh, okay, what are Italian dads? Or what are Catholic families? Or Latin?
Yeah.
You know, like, all these cultures have so much to do. Like, they're all the same. Yeah. It's just silly. But
it wouldn't surprise you if Fat Dan had an Uncle Vinny or Uncle Tony, right?
I'm sure he does.
Yeah. I would go back to Ohio, and my dad didn't have any brothers, but his best friend I just called uncle, and he'd yell at me like, why are your pants so saggy? What are you trying to be? You know, all right, I get it.
Yeah.
You know? Like, everyone's like that.
Yeah.
But I went on their show, Just Kidding News, recently, and I was only, like, I guess, white guy there, even though I'm not that white. White is, in Caucasian, is just a weird term anyways.
Well,
right?
Yeah, and especially in California, where we're a majority minority
state.
So.
And it depends on where you want to go. Like, technically, I guess I'm fucking Basque, you know, and then they moved to Argentina, and then we moved here.
Yeah.
So whatever the fuck you want to call me, but I'm lighter skinned than Bart and his friends.
Right.
And then all the white jokes are coming. You know, I said something about, and they're like, oh, that's what white people do, huh? I'm like, I don't even know. I don't know white jokes. Yeah. I don't know what we do.
Exactly.
And it's very frustrating because I'm trying to say, look, you don't understand. Like, we actually have a pretty close relationship with Bart.
Right.
It's one of Mike's best buds. Yeah. Mike's down there all the time. we do things with them all the time. They're right. Here, you're there, whatever,
him
whatever.
And Gio go back and forth all the time. She's obviously Mexican and he's Chinese, and they just crush each other all the time.
Yeah, and within this gym culture, that's not uncommon.
Yeah.
And it's not... there isn't anything behind it.
It's a normal locker room talk as opposed to what Donald Trump was trying to claim was locker room talk.
Exactly. I think
and he was talking more about sexual harassment, which is a totally different ballgame.
Yeah. Completely different thing,
I think there's something different, too, about the platforms you choose. Like, when you speak that way in a political platform or a large pop media platform, there's a reason that people do podcasts and a reason people do YouTubes and the reason that there's more like this private sector of entertainment.
Right.
Because, one... you like similar to Facebook, I guess. Kind
freedom
of,
going, speech is actually freedom of speech.
Yeah, you say whatever the fuck you want. Two, especially us. Three, everything we say is with a glint of humor behind it.
Right.
I don't think we've ever said anything on here that we're dead serious about.
Nothing's ever all that factual either.
Right. But when even when we're talking about training, you know, like we're joking about everything. That's just how we roll. So then you would think the audience would understand that. Like, hey, we're not on... whatever fucking, I don't even know what TV show, The View. Yeah, we're
CNN
not,
or whatever.
Yeah, whatever the fuck. We're not on there talking. I say The View because Ape Man's in the house. I know that's his favorite show. So, you know, we're not talking to fucking Barbara Walters.
Right,
right.
Exactly.
And so, like, the audience needs to understand the perspective of all that.
Well, and the thing is that we're making fun of the stereotypes. We're not making fun of them.
We're
making fun of the stereotypes. That's why they're. That's why it's funny. At least that's why it's funny to us.
Yeah, it's very true.
So, anyway, I just thought I would bring that up and sort of clear the air a little bit. Bart Kwan was not uncomfortable with us when he was on.
Right.
Poor Bart.
Bart has spent more time on camera than
our gym is pretty diverse.
It's
a lot of different people.
In we got Filipino Thunder in the other room there.
Yeah, who looks like a Mexican and is the size of a Tongan.
He's a little different. We're not going to say anything bad to him because he looks like he's going to kill somebody all the time.
Has the whitest mom ever.
Mm-hmm.
Mark even hired a Jew.
Yeah, see?
Yeah.
Yeah, someone's got to look after the dollars, right? There we go.
And Harry Potter, the guys.
He said it, not me. He said it.
And Harry Potter, the guys that deal with all the money are like gross little ugly gremlins. They're like the bankers in Harry Potter world.
They all
watch Harry Potter. Say something about it.
They all got the green shades, green.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So gross.
Anyway, so now these are my two issues. We can go on with the rest of the script now.
I think we talked about it once, and then also it might have been a YouTube comment or elsewhere. I think we talked about it, and it might have gotten heat, but. About USAPL Nationals going on right now.
Right.
Right.
That example you even said, Ray Williams squatted 1,000 pounds in sleeves.
Right.
Eric Lillibridge, who could argue is the best squatter in the world right now, squatted 1060 in
wraps. Maybe one of the better squatters of all time with all the world records he set.
Yeah, yeah. He squatted 1,000 pounds, whatever, seven times in meets or whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah.
All the time. These numbers are starting to clash in this drug test of the world or not. And I do think you can make a strong argument, not trying to be this IPF backer, but a lot of lifters are taking a more serious approach to their programming and planning that happen to compete in the IPF. Not to say that these others don't,
right?
Like, whatever that means or not. Like, you hear more about these guys doing research and you hear about more of these guys getting coaches even,
right?
Where, like, who coaches some of these other people, right? They're just, like, going and smashing weights, right?
Right.
And whether the program is perfect or not, I think everyone in the world would agree, whether it's business, school, lifting, that having a plan is better than not having a plan, even if that plan's not optimal.
Right.
Right? Like, with anything, right?
If you following something,
you're still going to, Mark, you have trouble reading, but if you plan to read every night at 6, you'll do a little bit better than if you never plan to read.
Absolutely.
You know? And so I just think it's nuts, you know? Like, our boy L.S. McLean benches 500.
Right.
He weighs 200 pounds. Like, that's fucking so strong.
Yeah.
And I don't know what the world record is. It's Huck.
Huck Finn, maybe.
524 is the all-time world record at 198, and LS benched, I think, 495 or whatever the kilo is at 205.
Yeah.
Jeez.
You know? Like, that's insane. Garrett Griffin's in that range. You know, my point is that there's a group of, like, 10 lifters, regardless of federation, regardless of whatever, and they're all strong
as
shit.
Here's the other thing about it is, you know, we do always point out that it is drug-tested and not necessarily drug-free. However, that doesn't mean that everybody's on drugs.
No.
You know, every world record that's set doesn't it's impossible, I think.
And then opposite,
that it would all be set by people that are abusing, because how are they, first of all, how are they getting past the drug test? I do understand there are ways to get past the drug test, but I just don't think all the lifters and coaches and everybody's that sophisticated that everyone's going to pass it. Of course, there's cheating going on. Of course, there's some people probably not following the rules to a T and taking some things that are on the banned substances list. But some of these people are breaking these all-time world records, whether they are beating, you know, former non-drug tested athletes. They may be beating. So
yeah,
it's impressive, no matter how you slice it.
I think another issue too is just human nature to blanket state everything.
Yeah,
like people say that anyone in the USPA, SPF, IPA, non-drug tested feds are on drugs.
Right,
which is just not the case either.
No,
you know, like.
Yeah, we know many lifters, yeah.
Right. You know, within super training or friends or whatever that don't take any performance enhancing mm-hmm. and still go to non-tested meets just because maybe they like that fed or their federation, their friends compete there.
Yeah, right. That's where they've got the support, whatever.
It's close by. It's at their home gym or whatever the case. So I think, you know, obviously the moral of the story. I like 90s sitcoms because they always have a moral of the story in every video.
Ties it in. Will Smith ties it in at the end.
Full House, all that shit. And Uncle Phil's giving you a life lesson.
I think we all learned an important lesson like from South Park.
Yeah, yeah, all that shit. But the point
learned important life lessons from Bill Cosby.
So sad.
I know.
Poor Bill. I never actually found him funny, though, either. So it's like easy
you
for
never
me
watched,
to like him.
You never watched Fat Albert, that's why.
Yeah, you never watched Fat Albert.
And the original. I watched like a little bit of The Cosby Show, and I've seen a little bit of stand-up, and the one where he's talking to kids all day, which obviously just looks so wrong now.
The one thing that he said that's always cracked me up was he said, guys, if you're trying to imagine what giving birth to a baby is like, imagine taking your lower lip and pulling it up over the top of your head.
Not true.
That would hurt.
USAPL, we're on the topic. We have it going in the background right now, the Raw Nationals.
You're watching some of this shit right now. Yeah. I don't believe I sponsored this, by the way, and we got a free logo. Does anybody know? Does anybody know if we did?
No one in this building. I already asked earlier.
I don't think we did.
Something new that they're trying that I guess is semi-controversial, which I don't find it that controversial, but I guess Facebook and things, threads have been going nuts, is that they made, which I think is a good business move, they made a premiere.
Prime time
session where who knows how many lifters they have, right? They have 1,300 mm-hmm. lifters this weekend, which is a whole nother topic. And they took whatever it is, top 10, top 20 qualifying totals. Those individuals get to lift during this prime time
right.
to try to up the live stream, to try to up the viewership in person, to try right. to up, obviously, the competitiveness. I think the controversy comes mostly from people that maybe didn't have a good qualifying but still think they're in the run for a medal.
Right.
So they have to compete at 8 in the morning. Yeah. These other people get to lift at 6 at night and already know what you totaled.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is...
Yeah. That's a little hinky.
A little bit. And in powerlifting, how often does it really come down to a kilo or two?
Yeah. Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, but not that often, you know?
Yeah.
Like, normally, someone just kind of clearly beats you. If you're stronger, you're stronger often.
Yeah.
I got to say, you know, first of all, I'll just be transparent. I have very sour grapes with the USAPL and IPF due to the fact that they're blocking other companies from coming in. They're blocking other companies from giving them money and supporting powerlifting further because, in my opinion, they've taken money under the table from SBD. That's my opinion. But, you know, I get really frustrated when I hear about a national meet going on with 1,300 lifters. That is a terrible representation of powerlifting. It's a terrible representation of what it's like at the top. Because
yeah,
there should
like
not be
smoky in the Olympics.
There should not be 1,300 lifters at this event. There should be maybe 50 or maybe 100.
100, yeah.
1,300 probably represents the amount of football players are in the entire National Football League. And those are the best athletes, some of the best athletes America has to offer. But to me, this is, I don't agree with this at all. I don't like seeing people lift fucking 200 pounds. You should not only be able to, you shouldn't be able to only lift for power lift for like a year and be at the national level unless you're a mutant.
Yeah.
It makes no sense to me.
Just to play devil's advocate a little bit, even though I agree 100%. One, they did change the, qualifier and made it semi-legitimate.
Made it a little harder.
Yeah, it's still like, I agree. It's still...
What's the difference between the number last year and the number this year?
So I think it's more this year, which is also kind of a good sign for powerlifting also, though, if you want to look at it that way, right? Like, people are just getting better.
Yeah.
Because I literally, and don't quote me again, but the qualifier for someone around my weight last year was like 1350, which I do, you know, fairly easy. Turned to like 1500,
right?
Which... is still not national level, right? That's why I agree. It's not elite, but it is at least more difficult.
What I would imagine as a problem is then if there's still 1,300 people there, that they're making way too many categories for you to enter.
So that's what I was going to say, is that I'm eating popcorn.
The qualifying total is probably in every category, right? It's probably collegiate, team,
so
and
that's
so on.
The issue is they throw everyone.
That's bullshit.
They throw everyone in the same weekend, and that's a problem we find in every federation, though, where there's like Masters 1, which is 30 to 35, and Masters 2, 35 to 40, yeah. And Masters 3. Like, when does it stop? And then there's junior, teen, right? So then there's literally an age category every 3 to 6 years
right.
that all these people are going into, and then they're throwing them, you know, I'm a national champion. Like, what? Of 36-year-olds born right. in June on Tuesday. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
so,
yeah.
like,
yeah.
you start to get a little extreme with that. And like I said, that's every federation, right? That right. people are promoting these state, county, local records. Whereas if you do want the sports advance, like, yes, there's kind of a semi-pro with all these leagues, right? Mm-hmm. There's arena football, mm-hmm. there's the NBDL, and there's AAA baseball. Mm-hmm. But then really there's just like the best of the best competing against each other.
Yeah. I think they're taking advantage of it. It's 100% wrong to me, because they're taking advantage of the fact that everybody wants to talk about going to nationals. Because if they open the floodgates, like, they have a state qualifier? They have a qualifier to go to states?
See, I think you just qualify for nationals, even though they call...
So, okay, so...
They call some meet state right. championships, but I don't think you qualify for that. I think
they would use that as part of the...
I think you can go... I may be wrong, go quote me, because I've only done yeah. one USAPL meet.
Right.
But I think you can compete at any USAPL meet in a certain date range, you know?
And then
from,
you can go to the
from
state.
December to June or whatever. Uh-huh. And then you can go to nationals that year if you qualify.
And so the frustrating part is... They leave the state ones open, and there's probably not that much participation. It's probably not that crazy to do it.
Actually, I think the state one me and Marcus did last year, right. it was technically a NorCal championship or something. But
right.
yeah, why not take it a step further, and you do a state championship, and then the top five from there.
Right.
And maybe it's even fucking weighted somehow, right? There's more people in California than there are right. than Montana.
Right.
So maybe the top five from California, the top one from Montana, the top right. one, you know, some shit like that.
Yeah.
And they get to go to nationals and duke it out.
It's possible that the economics don't work out.
100%.
I just don't think.
There's a lot more planning.
I just don't think
bullshit involved.
Everyone belongs at nationals. Everyone belongs on a local level. And a lot of people may belong on the state level, but not on the national level. It's just,
Yeah,
I just think it's a joke.
But that's kind of an issue from the top down too. I was watching IPF Worlds, and US, you know, for those that don't know, we're fairly mediocre in weightlifting.
Yeah,
and mm-hmm. we're fairly dominant in powerlifting.
Yeah.
So you go to IPF Worlds, which, you know, whether you like them or not, I think you can say that they're probably the most organized and most legitimate world competition we have in our sport. Even
yeah.
though it's still sad. And you see, I think I was watching John Hack and Brett Gibbs go at it.
Right.
Two guys that are ridiculous. 181 yeah. lifters or 183,
insane.
Whatever. And they both total like over 1,700, right? Squatting high sixes, benching mid fours, pulling mid sevens. And in their flight, there's maybe only 10 people. It's more proper size.
Right.
But there's other countries. John Hack opened with like a 650-pound squat.
Jesus.
And then the next kid opened with a 400-pound squat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he was from El Salvador or something.
Yeah.
You
right.
know what I mean?
Right.
Where the Olympics, even in weightlifting, like
yeah.
I think you go to Worlds, and then depending on how many podiums, don't quote me again, these are all half-ass facts. Depending on how many podiums do spots you get at Worlds in weightlifting is how many spots we get mm-hmm. for the Olympics. And then we choose who we want to fill those spots.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
So we had four podium or maybe point system at Worlds 2 years ago. So then we got four people to go.
Right.
Or three chicks and one dude. And then we choose which dude and chicks we want to go through our process. And then they go to the Olympics and compete against whatever process they went again.
Yeah.
But if me and you bought a country right now, we would still have to compete at this Worlds
right.
before we went to the Olympics.
Yeah.
It's not like, hey, this is slingshot town and now we
right.
get to go to the Olympics. And that's kind of what
so you're saying.
See
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah.
We would still have to qualify through international
yeah.
Source
yeah.
rather
even,
than just claim it.
And, you know, the USAPL isn't the only ones guilty of this.
No, everyone does it.
Yeah, and it's done in weightlifting also. They do nationals. There's fucking 500 people there.
Yeah.
It's just ridiculous. It makes me ashamed to be part of the sport because Everyone's so fucking money hungry, and that's 100% what this is about. It's a weekend of powerlifting where the USAPL is making hundreds of thousands of dollars, charging $125, $150 bucks per entry, having all these lifters lift there in one day. And I know that a lot of people think it's positive, but I'm just pointing out a lot of the negative sides to it. There are a lot of positives to it because people are going there having good experiences. People are going there hitting PRs and stuff, but to me, this is not the way powerlifting should be done. Shouldn't be racing through this many people. How many platforms are there? Five or six?
Yeah, I think there's five.
At the same time, to me, every powerlifting meet always should only have one platform because that's the, you spend 12 weeks, 14 weeks, 16 weeks on a training cycle. You spend all this time. Why can't you have fucking 30 seconds to yourself on the platform where all eyes are on you? Why would there be so many different platforms going on in one time?
Yeah, it is a little hard, you know, because we are big proponents of everyone powerlifting, and we want them we want everyone to compete.
Right.
But there's also a point where, like, all right, man, I really want to go to the NBA.
Just don't call it nationals.
Yeah, I don't get to go to the NBA.
Call it something else.
I don't get to go play against these guys, you know, because they're still – it's a little bit, you know, not to get political again, but it's a little bit like, hey, you came in 10th, Timmy, here's your medal.
Yeah.
You know?
So it's participation trophy time.
Yeah, so there's a little bit of that involved in powerlifting where – it is cool because anybody can compete in it. But what Mark's saying is, like, not anybody can compete at the highest level.
They don't deserve to. They haven't been doing it long enough. They're not fucking strong enough.
And maybe
that's the biggest problem.
And yeah, maybe they're just not that guy. Like, it's everything else, you know. But for some reason, because, like, all of us admit, like, powerlifting is a sport for the people that can't do anything else kind of thing, you know, right? Like,
those that can't teach.
It's kind of like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
certainly.
But then that doesn't mean, that you're going to be the best at this sport that's for anybody.
Yeah, exactly. Let's talk about something more positive. What about our boy, Steve Gentile, dropping 455 pounds on his chest, but that surviving? That's the positive part.
That was painful.
The guy's like goddamn Superman. How did he survive that? That looked like that would kill me, by the way.
It was kind of more one side than the other, too.
Yeah.
Slammed his left lung or something.
He was like fine like 2 days later.
Yeah, he doesn't give a shit. I think a day before that, too, there's a rig at Barbell that's like just a squat rig, and there's a bunch of things, but I think there's a pull-up bar. It's actually more of a structural thing. It's not a real pull-up bar. I think he measured it's like 16 feet in the air or 15 feet, and Gentile just jumps off 2 feet and just grabs it like he's about to dunk. Like, he's just a freak athlete, man. He's so athletic. And he's tall, but like 15 feet's no joke, you know?
He can grab it?
Yeah, he jumped and grabbed it. It's on Instagram.
Holy shit. Wow.
Yeah, and I think he said he measured it. It was like 15
I saw a video of a fat Asian kid that he filmed in slow motion.
Doing the same thing,
trying to touch the thing.
Yeah,
right?
That's because Steve did it like a day before. Just to prove, like, hey, this isn't 9 feet. Like, this isn't easy.
Right.
Yeah, he's a freak, man.
Yeah, now he's back, you know, benching like 575 and shit. And
yeah, he don't care. Yeah, he's been going nuts lately. I think he pulled 825 in the gym, whatever. Bench 585, and then he's still trying to figure a squat out, but he squatted 7 for a few reps.
Jesse Norris competes tomorrow.
Maybe tonight?
Oh, yeah.
Because there is that prime time, so I don't know what the hell is going on, but I know his weight class, because our boy Lou competed this morning, so I think tonight might be Jesse Norris. Ben Rice is back in action. I think he's there. I bet Ben will have a really good meet. That'll be cool to see him.
Yeah, he's a beast.
Compete, yeah.
Bryce Lewis?
That might be today or tomorrow. Bryce Lewis's weight class, I used to think, like, oh, man, I could go and sneak in. Like, it was less competitive.
Yeah, now it's savage.
Yeah, now it's fucking full of people.
Too. What is he, 231?
231. Who knows? He might total 2,000 pounds.
Yeah, well... yeah, what, he squat 800 pounds or something?
I think he squatted 7, bench 5, and pull 8. And those were all, they're gym lifts, but they're all within his fucking realm for sure.
Yeah.
And then even, obviously, all the chicks are going nuts. Every chick in this fucking thing pulls 400 pounds now.
You're dropping weight, Silent Mike? What's going on?
I'm trying to get skinny.
Why?
Just trying to get jacked.
For the fans?
Yeah. For Instagram.
It's winter bikini season.
Hmm.
Yeah, I figure I'd get a head start. I was that fat. I need a year to get skinny again.
Oh, all the way till...
it'll be July before
we know
it. All the way
till summertime?
Yeah, it'll be July before we know it. I also heard that Ape Man was going to make me a mankini.
They should.
That's what they told me.
They should. They should do something for you.
Yeah, I know. I just asked for a hat, and they gave me a snarl.
What's the...
I was like, sorry.
Yeah, the raw hat. I asked for that
one, too. The podcast, not you, son.
I asked for that hat that says raw on it.
That's all I want. That's all I really want.
I asked for that. I can't get it.
It's probably sold out, knowing how popular they are.
I don't know what happened.
I don't know.
I can't get one, though.
Everyone in the world's wearing their shit. I've seen their shit in the weirdest places. I was at an Attitude Nation. We can talk about that a little bit, too. John North, the Cal Strength weightlifter, Just had a cardiac arrest, I believe. I don't know if you saw that.
And I heard.
I think he was pronounced dead for like 5 or 10 minutes.
He's a big reason why Cal Strength is popular.
Huge reason. Our boy Charlie went down there, and Charlie told me he's doing better.
Big personality. Good lifter.
And yeah, so I'm glad to hear that he's okay. But I went to one of his meets, which was actually pretty cool. He's trying to make like our sports more fun.
Right.
So he's got a live DJ spinning the whole thing. He's on the mic hyping people up.
Currently, there's only like one main federation in weightlifting, right?
I think there's only one.
And he like made his own.
He made his own, which is kind of cool. And so, yeah, it's all hype. Music's going loud. Like, they're playing good music. It's kind of reminded me more of a session here at Super Training than a meet, which is cool.
Yeah, that's great.
Especially for weightlifting, which often if you guys have been to, like, a serious weightlifting competition, it's more like golf or tennis.
A little bit like the competition you did at Caffeine and Kilos, maybe.
100%.
Music going. You don't need a singlet.
Yeah, it was a lot like that. Like you do need a singlet. Right. And I think they weigh you in and stuff. But, like, the energy was fucking sick.
And he was about to do a bodybuilding show.
I think he's done some. And, yeah,
he was a few weeks out.
Yeah. But I saw 8-man over that meet.
Damn.
There's a bunch of guys in 8-man.
Even weightlifting?
Yeah.
They're turning their backs on powerlifting. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. I didn't see that one.
Sellouts. Kinda.
Clean and jerk and snatch. Sellouts. That's what we're going to do now?
Yeah, they don't give a shit.
Wow.
I'll sell a shirt to anybody.
That's a bunch of bullshit.
Pretty soon they're going to change the name to Ape Snatch or something.
Yeah, I heard they try to sponsor a Kardashian.
Really?
Yeah. They really don't give a shit.
Try to sponsor that ass.
Just a left butt cheek.
Yeah.
What's up with Jennifer Thompson? Is she competing?
Yeah.
Did you see her doing the 525-pound hold on Instagram?
How bad is it that I bench 405, or I have. I probably will never do it the rest of my life. But I would
not if you're dropping weight.
Yeah, I would never want to hold 500 pounds in my hand. That seems so scary. I think my forearms would bust, and she's holding it like it's nothing.
Well, I got to tell you, like, it would be really hard for me to hold it. Like, she held it for like 6 seconds at the top, and that's a lot of strain on your joints, on your tendons and ligaments to hold it. I mean, I'd rather press it than
hold
it.
Who's the Chinese weightlifter? I think it's Liu. I'm going to fuck up his last name, but he's like a little guy.
Look how close this girl's stance is. Oh. She's not going to pee. That's guaranteed.
That's why.
That's guaranteed to prevent squirting.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Liu, whatever. Front rack held like 700-800 pounds, like
Jesus
static
Christ.
Hold front, like that would crush me in half.
Yeah.
On my back, let alone my front.
I've had 500 pounds in my hand like once or twice back in the old shirt days. Yeah.
Way too scary.
Yeah,
I don't recognize any of these people. I was hoping we'd tune in and we'd see
friends. Anybody but nobody.
I think our girl Katie Ann's competing tonight.
Yeah,
she's gonna fucking go nuts. Yeah. She's going nuts. The other homegirl Rory, she's been going nuts. She benched like 215 for a bunch of reps.
I think
going
back to what you were saying earlier about, you know, some of the drug tested people catching up to the others, I think you know, a big factor is that the training is so difficult. The training that like Katie Ann does is not, you can't just like go and work out.
Yeah.
I was watching a video of a famous YouTuber the other day, kind of more of a fitness person. And he was like, oh, well, I'm going to the gym. Like he was like, you know, getting his car fixed or something at the time. And somebody like Katie Ann or somebody even like ourselves, you can't really just do that. You can't really just be like, oh, I got 30 or I have an hour. I can go to the gym.
Yeah, let's get a quick workout.
You could potentially go to the gym and maybe do some lat pull downs and do some different things. But you can't really go in and like get your squat workout, you know, and someone like Katie Ann, she's squatting, benching, deadlifting.
Yeah.
Almost every training session, I think she does it 3 times a week.
Yeah.
The amount of weights that she uses would be impressive for guys to move around.
Yeah.
So, you know, it takes a lot of preparation. Different. And my point is that you have to be well rested for those workouts. Mm-hmm. You have to be really well fed.
Yeah.
So it's no longer just you training in the gym for an hour or 2 hours, however long it takes to get done with your training session. It's a 24-hour process.
And
I think that's why we're seeing people advance so much. Even a big boy like Ray Williams, he still has to make sure he's getting his rest and stuff. Maybe he doesn't eat as cleanly as some others. I've seen him, you know, post that he's just crushing some food. But he still has to make sure he gets the calories, which that's not easy either.
Yeah. You got to be in a way different mental place than some either a casual lifter or even like, you know, not to hate on certain sports, but someone that does Pilates seriously or does Spartan races seriously. Like, I feel you could not
be... It's a different intensity.
Yeah, it really is.
There's a lot of pressure on your body.
Yeah, it's a lot of different preparation. And then another thing I think that's making kind of these lifters excel a lot is that genetics are coming this way. Like,
yeah.
Katie Ann, I think, told us that she had a track and field scholarship for the Buckeyes.
Yeah,
right.
Like, and she got sick or injured and didn't. But genetically,
yeah,
the Buckeyes are, like, Ohio State's not a fucking joke. Like, that's right. Top D1 program, and she went for maybe even it was cross country. Right. Doesn't matter if it was related or not. The point is that within her is that athleticism, right, genetically and or discipline and a combination, yeah, of both, right, that already made her at a very elite level.
Yeah.
To let alone, like, get into this.
Brooke Wells, right, isn't really trying powerlifting, and she deadlifts 400 pounds,
and she had
a benches 200.
Yeah, she had a full ride to Missouri. You know, yeah. Even Bryce Lewis, I think, played D1 volleyball.
Yeah,
like, it doesn't matter what you did. Yeah. Like, that means he's explosive. That's, he's coordinated. So you know what I mean? Yeah. It's insane.
For a not tall guy, Filipino Thunder just fell out of his chair. Imagining Bryce Lewis playing volleyball.
Yeah, can you imagine him spiking the ball? It's gonna be so funny.
I bet you had a pretty good vert.
He probably did.
Yeah,
he probably did.
He moves awesome when he was in here squatting and stuff.
I mean, when I first found him, he did a lot of mobility stuff on, yeah, YouTube, and he would do different, like, running drills and stuff. Yeah, he looked crazy athletic.
Going back to Katie Ann for a second, though, I mean, she's, like, engineered her life so that she can actually have those long training sessions.
I think a lot of people,
and recover and all that stuff. I mean, like, she's treating herself as though she were a professional athlete, yeah, in this sport.
Yeah.
And
I think a lot of these people don't have, like, a typical job. I think you just said Ray Williams is a coach, right? Like,
yeah.
I'm sure that the coaching hours and stuff, they probably allow him, like, maybe during the football season, maybe it's harder,
right,
yeah,
for him to get the same training sessions in.
But the
maybe
rest
he
of the
adjusts
time,
accordingly. You know? Yeah,
that's, like, the one big part of me that does want, like, powerlifting to go, like, whether it's mainstream or Olympics or something, to give, like, athletes like that already treat it serious, like, right, the recognition that they treat it serious, or even, right, us, like, if I end up in, like, the fucking D league of this thing, you know what I mean? Like, because I feel like treated, right, that way, it'd be cool to be looked at that way, even, right, though the sport's not.
Yeah, it'd be cool if Ray Williams just made 50 grand a year just for being himself.
Yeah. I side note, but not, once again, another 50% fact of mine. I think Shaco was quoted at,
that's
saying,
a great thing, 50% facts.
Yeah.
Facts.
I think we're going to call this episode that. 50%
facts. I think
could be true.
Shaco. Yeah.
Be false.
Yeah. Shaco said, when asked if powerlifting
in Russian,
yeah, which already takes my percentage down to 25.
Yeah, yeah.
That if the powerlifting were to make it to Olympics, he believes it should be push pull. Maybe you could Google that.
I think I've seen that. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. That might have been when we interviewed him.
Yeah, I don't know.
Up at Jesse Burdick's gym.
And I think that's kind of cool.
And the ruler of that would be Kirill Serkev, because he's done a 881 deadlift.
Yeah.
And a 738 bench press.
What's KK?
KK can bench almost 600 pounds. Yeah, 939. Yeah.
840 or 850. And
mm-hmm. Yeah, 9.
Trying to think.
940, yeah.
You start getting into some lightweights. You got fucking Jeremy Hamilton.
Yeah.
He could probably bench 540, 550, pull 815.
Yeah.
You know, that'd be
West
pretty
Side
cool.
Had some really great lifters like that had a really good
what's
push
his name?
Pull.
Spiegel?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, he's 625 or 650 and then 900. Yeah.
God damn.
Yeah, that's pretty sick.
Yeah.
But I kind of think
this is it right
in
here.
Terms of rules, that kind of makes sense, right? Mm-hmm. Like, what? No one ever argues. Yeah. Sometimes they'll argue a pause on a bench. But when everyone's talking controversy of a shit federation or shit lift, mm-hmm. IPF, IPA, USPA, it doesn't matter. When you're talking about shit judging, it's 90-80% about the squat.
Yeah. Well, and also, too, you think about it. Like, that gives you enough. It gives you enough information about somebody, yeah, whether they're strong or not, right?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I obviously like squats. And I also
think, but squats would still be a big part of it. You'd still squat all the time.
You would pause. Yeah, yeah, you'd front squat, pause squat to make a part of it, to accessorize. But I also think that it might be less common to find someone that can bench a lot and pull a lot.
It can be.
You know what I mean? Like,
it can be.
Sometimes you find guys that like squat a lot and bench a lot, or even squat a lot and maybe pull a lot.
Right.
Because often the stereotypical build are opposites. Right.
Yeah.
A bencher, big old tits, tiny little arms, polar kind
big
of
old titties.
Long arms,
yeah,
short legs.
Yeah, you know, the interesting thing is a lot of the guys that have the longer arms, they end up being able to bench pretty
a
good
lot of
sometimes,
them.
You know. I mean, Ryan Spencer, he always knocks himself that he doesn't have a good bench, but he was benching, you know, 315 and 325,
yeah,
or so. I think he did that in competition.
His form's not really good either. Sorry,
Spence. Yeah.
Oh, his elbows are out all the time.
Yeah. And I don't know if he ever take time to work on it. You know, there's other factors.
He has.
He's tried.
That, yeah, he's tried. Except that
it's just hard for his body type or whatever.
Yeah. But same thing, like Smokey comes in every day, complaining about his deadlift, but like, gee, you've pulled like 550 at 181. If that's your weak lift, that's still pretty strong.
It's very strong. And I mean, benching over 3 at, you know, 165, while it might not be earth shattering,
yeah, it's strong.
Is still strong.
Yeah,
you know, and then plus what did he deadlift the other day? 660.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
so strong.
So this I don't know if exactly it's a quote, but it says another crucially important aspect of raw powerlifting is that only this type of powerlifting has a chance to get into the Olympics. Maybe powerlifting will have to say goodbye to one of the exercises, squats, for example. So maybe there will be only two exercises, as in weightlifting,
I think,
bench press and the
deadlift. Logistically, it might make sense too, right? Like hours at a facility.
Safety.
Safety, yeah. Spotters. How long the meet goes.
The most criticized is squats, without question.
Yeah, it's interesting.
So that's...
I wouldn't be against it.
This one was actually on the JTS strength site. But he's probably said it more than once.
Yeah, I don't know. I just know someone asked me about it and said, like, what are your thoughts? I was like, I don't really have thoughts.
But I would tend to agree.
Logistically, I think it makes more sense, even though I would like to see squats too. You never know. You never know what the hell's going on.
What do we got going on with Tom Brady? Tom Brady comes back, and then
I got him on my fantasy team.
You know what's
funny?
You know what's,
he goes ape shit.
You know what's funny is, you know, on ESPN, they're just going crazy about him, and it's like he is amazing. He's definitely one of the best quarterbacks of all time. There's zero question of any of that. He has the stats and the wins, and I think everybody admires how intense he is and how much time he puts into it. He's the true professional. To the fullest. So he does deserve a lot of accolades.
Yeah.
However, he was suspended for cheating, and he came back and he whooped up on the fucking Browns. So everybody should fucking relax.
Poor Browns.
Everybody needs to just relax. He's not reached the status of Joe Montana. You know, he hasn't reached the status of Terry Bradshaw. You got to win 4 fucking Super Bowls to do that. And so he's been to a lot of Super Bowls. Mm-hmm. He's lost a couple, you know, unfortunately, because of the Manning brothers have kept him either out of the Super Bowl or beat him in the Super Bowl directly.
Right.
But I think Brady's got 3 championships, I think. Is that right, Marcus?
Brady's championships. 3?
3. Yeah.
They're playing,
so he's got
pretty
one
good
more to
general,
go. He's, and he's like 3-3, right? He went to 6, maybe?
That's a lot.
Yeah.
His career is so long.
Yeah. I mean, it's savage and it's amazing, like I said. And he probably will, regardless of whether he even wins another one, he probably still go down to the greatest. But he also has had the same coach the entire time.
Yeah. Which is rare.
I mean, on the same team the entire time.
Yeah. And on the same team the entire time. And then, you know, you got to give them credit also on this note is that they don't always seem to have the best players.
Ever.
They do such a great job with the players that they have. They bring up these guys like Julian Edelman and some of these guys that are not, they don't look like NFL superstars, you know.
Another team, maybe they got forgotten.
But on occasion, they do have like an absolute mutant like Gronkowski.
Randy Moss or whatever.
Yeah, they had Moss for
even
a
now
while.
They have, don't they have Martellus Bennett? He's a really good athlete.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Bennett, he's a fucking beast.
I think this is their year. This is his 4th, I think. I know they only beat the Browns, but.
I would imagine he would retire.
I know, but I think he wins the Super Bowl this year.
Hmm. I'd imagine he'd hang his shit up.
Everyone's hanging
possibly,
his shit
up.
Kevin Garnett just retired, right? Tim Duncan, Kobe.
Yeah. Did Tim Duncan finally retire?
Yeah.
Big Poppy.
Yeah. He retired. Everyone's retiring. The fucking tides are moving.
Hmm. Young guys coming through. Brady's, 38, 39?
Guy's old. Who's the quarterback?
I don't know. He's 40s.
Who's the young guy, though? There's not really a young guy. Like, Cam Newton, I guess. But I guess he's kind of inconsistent. Andrew Luck, but he had a bad year.
Yeah, and it's hard to see who's going to ride. Andrew Luck will be around.
I guess Aaron Rodgers is still kind of in his prime, right?
Yeah.
So he's kind of the young guy. Because, like, Drew Brees is getting kind of old.
Team's inconsistent, though. Yeah. Brees is old.
In the NBA, it's easier. Like, Steph Curry, Kevin Durant.
You got guys like the guy on... the Cowboys, Dak, like he's doing really well, but is he going to rise to the top? No. Is he going to be around in 3 years? Like once, you know, the NFL is amazing. Once people get tape on you, you're fucked.
Yeah,
once they watch you play a little bit.
I wonder if Luck's the guy. I hope he is. I like
Cam
Luck
Newton's
a lot.
Been getting blasted on this year.
Yeah.
You know, is he hurt again?
He had a concussion for 2 weeks, I think.
Jesus Christ, man. He's been getting smashed.
That seems pretty good, but not as good. And didn't the Broncos just get crushed last night?
The
The Broncos lose
the
last
Broncos
night?
Lost last week. I know that.
I think they lost last night too.
Did they play? Yeah.
I know they lost fucking Peyton Manning, but yeah. How do you go from like a Super Bowl team to?
Well, they're. I think they're like. If they did lose last night, they're like 4-2 maybe. But the Panthers have been getting destroyed. Poor Coach House.
Yeah, I know.
My favorite thing in the goddamn world. One of my favorite things on Instagram is seeing Coach House work out.
Yeah, he's always going full
blast, box squats and.
Yeah.
He's always going all in, and it's great to see like somebody like him. That enthusiastic about like you know coaching his guys and stuff.
Yeah, well, I think he talks about that a lot as a coach. Like, how are they supposed to respect you as a coach right. before if you don't get after it?
Yeah, look, Cowboys are fucking 4-1. Eagles are 3-1. The Eagles.
Yeah, why
are the
yeah.
good? Why are the Eagles good?
Even the Redskins are 3-2.
Yeah. Seahawks.
I feel like the Vikings. Jesus, I feel like the NFL.
Now is Bridgewater? Is he their quarterback?
I think he's injured.
The Vikings. Is he hurt?
Yeah. Yeah, he's injured. They're playing no
Adrian
Peterson.
Now the Falcons. The Falcons are putting up some points.
I like Matt Ryan.
Matty Ice putting up some points.
Come on over here, Marcus. We're talking football, buddy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
bring here. I feel like
come over here because I got to go to the bathroom.
I feel like the NFL. Maybe I don't know shit about baseball, so it's hard to say. But I feel like the NFL.
Ladies and gentlemen, Filipino Thunder.
I feel the Thunder. NFL. Teams can go from the best to the worst in a year, and that almost never happens in other sports.
Baseball, yeah.
Baseball, yeah. Maybe baseball. I don't know shit about baseball.
Free agency, maybe?
I guess, but like even in the NBA, the Thunder were top five in the West, maybe even top two, I can't remember, last year, and they lost Kevin Durant, which is arguably top three best player.
Right.
And they'll still be pretty good this year. Like they're not going to, you know, like we were talking about, like the Panthers just like, it looks like they're fucking falling apart, and they didn't even lose like Cam Newton. Or
1-4.
Piece. Yeah. And like you're supposed to be a Super Bowl team,
mm-hmm.
but like things go because I guess there's so many more moving pieces. I guess baseball does make sense because there's so many moving pieces. Yeah. You lose your center, and then all right, well that could really fuck things up.
Well, a huge thing is like they didn't have Cam for two games.
Yeah, poor Cam.
Yeah.
So
my fantasy team got fucked because
and even
Cam.
When they did have him, he was still kind of fucked up. Like he got nailed.
That first game, he got crushed. He should have been taken out the first game.
Why? Yeah. Why? I don't understand. I mean, I understand like the guy wants to play and they're
yeah.
But people Jesus were talking Christ, about he got hit hard.
He's got a lot of, I guess, controversy around
he
him,
scored
too.
On that play, though, right? The play that he got
yeah, they
hit?
Got crushed, yeah.
He got
the
hit
first
in the
time,
fucking
I think,
ear hole?
Yeah.
Yeah, blasted out of bounds.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They talk about Cam being treated unfairly, kind of similar to LeBron in the sense where because he's such a physical specimen,
mm-hmm.
that refs don't, like, call different things that wrong. They might call in like a skinny little quarterback.
Well, when you run, it's that he runs. It's not necessarily a specimen. He yeah. runs. When he leaves the pocket, you become a runner.
They're
going to
let him get
smashed.
Blasted. Poor guy.
Where look at Tom Brady. He runs maybe three times a year.
Tom Brady's too handsome. They'll get smashed.
Know? So, and then you touch Tom Brady in the pocket, and it's a penalty.
Yeah. And they, yeah. Well, but, just stuff like that. Or like so Steph Curry's 6'1 and 160 pounds. LeBron James 6'8 and 260.
Right.
It could be the same amount of contact, but it's going to look different. Right, and so then obviously Steph Curry gets the upper hand on those calls.
Yeah, and also too, like somebody like LeBron might not get credit for working hard because somebody's like, "Oh, well, look at the look at his stature, look at the way he's built. He might have this crazy genetics." And then somebody like Larry Bird from back in the day,
who
kind of looks gawky, like people are not associating not associating him with. Yeah, it is white and black. It's definitely a huge part of it. People are not associating with him with great genetics, but.
Well,
his athleticism was fucking insane. He's 6'9" too. Yeah, yeah. You know,
same thing. Me and Marcus have talked about Alex Smith and Kaepernick. Like, right. Alex Smith's got some wheels on him. You know, and everyone's like, "Oh, good thing we got this Kaepernick guy. He's way more athletic than our old guy." You know,
Andrew Luck.
Yeah,
Andrew Luck can run like a motherfucker.
Well, he's built like a white Cam Newton. The guy's kind of yoked. You know, he's fucking thick.
Yeah, whoever the running quarterback was that came out that same year, he was faster than. It might have been Cam Newton. I can't remember. I think who came out.
But yeah, Luck ran crazy times.
It was Cam Newton, yeah. Andrew Luck's quite a bit
Kaepernick's
faster.
Starting this week, yeah.
Is he?
Yeah, they're going to start him.
See how that goes.
Yeah, he can move.
The Niners are dead.
Well, you're 1-4. Who cares, right?
Yeah, might as well do something with him.
Yeah.
The Bowman's gone for the season. They're over.
What are the Raiders? The 3-2?
Yeah. They're playing all right.
The Raiders are kicking ass right now.
Where they at?
We got to go to a goddamn game.
Raiders. I've never been to a Raiders game. 4-1. Oh, dang.
They're kicking ass right now.
Yeah, I thought they were more like 3-2.
Derek Carr looks amazing.
Derek Carr. Oh, maybe Derek Carr's the young guy of the future.
I always like watching the Steelers. So. Yeah. I like watching Roethlisberger. He's a mutant.
I like watching him get hit.
I like teams.
Who's bigger, Roethlisberger or Newton?
Roethlisberger.
They're both
huge. He's just more like mass, yeah?
Yeah, he's probably
250 pounds.
Yeah. That's a big dude.
That's a big-ass quarterback.
6'2 or something?
That's so funny. You get so excited. Six, like, four. You get past the tackle and the guard or the guard or whatever. Then you might get past, like, the fullback or the running back. Then you're all excited to try to tackle the quarterback, but he's 250.
Yeah.
Even Tom Brady's huge. Tom Brady's, like, what, 6'4", 6'5"?
Like 6'4".
And he's probably 220?
Something maybe. That. I'm sure he put weight on.
Yeah.
But so big in scheme of athletics, like Jordan was 6'6", 205.
Yeah. I know.
You know?
Yeah,
it's like a noodle.
Yeah, it is. It's so small in comparison to even like Brady, who people would call small.
That's probably the same size as Usain Bolt.
Probably very similar.
Probably so exact same
Usain
size.
Might be, yeah, maybe
a little short, maybe a tiny bit shorter.
Yeah. I think maybe 6'4", 6'5", whatever.
Yeah, maybe an inch shorter.
Yeah, but similar builds. Very similar.
And then Bones.
Bones, I think, 6'4", 6'5", 215, 220. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's the build.
We got to go to the UFC, too. December 12th.
They're going to be here?
Here at the Golden Arena. Paige Van Zandt's fighting.
Oh, my God.
And I don't know who else.
They know.
Yeah.
No, that would be awesome to go to that. My birthday is the 10th. I'm going to be fucking 40. Yeah, it's like
it's all over now.
A birthday / funeral. Yeah.
I remember going to your 30th birthday party. And your brother-in-law made a chicken wing martini.
Yeah, so good. So gross, actually.
It was disgusting.
Is it so real? Fat.
Buffalo, yeah, well, it was real that day. Yeah, he made it, yeah.
Something like that in like a Bloody Mary.
Wing garnish, blue cheese garnish around the top. It was disgusting.
That sounds awful.
And it was so hot. Because it had red hot sauce in it.
Yeah,
it was bad.
He rimmed the glass with.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I don't want that.
It was amazing.
Rim job.
Rim job the glass.
Marcus looks too happy to be that close to Jim.
I know, right? You got to make the best of your situation.
I guess.
Marcus is my buddy.
What else we got going on?
Nothing.
Basketball season started.
Why? It just ended.
I know. I thought it just ended too.
Basketball should be like the Olympics. Every 4 years, they should have a season.
It's really
every 4 years.
It is a long season.
It goes on forever.
It's a long season.
I like the goddamn stadium. I know we talked about the arena a little bit on the last podcast, I think, but it was awesome.
Yeah, I'm excited.
I haven't gotten up to those nosebleeds, but I heard more bad things about it, too. I heard people are getting, like, vertigo and feeling like they're going to fall.
Well,
I heard they've had lawsuits already because people have, like, just stumbled, like, just because they're center
drunk?
Of gravity.
Yeah,
well,
the first
that
two
too.
Shows. The
center of gravity is, like, off, like, because of how steep it is.
In part, it's because of how steep it is, and in part, it's because how high the roof is. How, like, when we switch from...
They said the big screen kind of fucks you up, too, because you got the big screen in front of you, how high the roof is, and then where the court is, and when you go to stand up, you just feel like you're moving around.
You know how disorienting it was the first time that we squatted on the outward-facing monolith?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like that.
Yeah, we all
but
almost
it's
shit ourselves.
You're going to feel like you're falling forward.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I feel lost.
Yeah,
because your eyes don't have anything to lock into.
Yeah,
I think that's part of the problem. I don't think it's really that much steeper than other places.
Yeah.
It's just
if we go, we can just all hold each other.
Yeah,
but
I wonder
where eight man gear.
Where's
hold
Muriel? She doesn't she have the UFC hookup? Can she get us some tickets?
Mario.
I'll try to get to the UFC.
Well, Muriel, that's a good one.
I'm gonna do some asking with the contact that we came up with a few weeks ago. I'm gonna ask exactly what we're gonna get out of that.
Oh, that would be good.
The contact.
I can get us tickets for the UFC.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yeah, I can do that. Yeah. I think I can hook
just
that
call
up.
Dana.
Yeah, I'll text him.
Hey, Mr. Dana.
I'll text him up.
That'd be a good time to try to sneak Rogan in here.
I know. Is he? He's not always at every.
He's not going to be doing that show.
Dang it, Rogan.
Is he not going to be doing that?
It's a Fox.
Top secret.
It's a Fox. He doesn't do it anymore.
I wonder
those.
Maybe he just wants to. Then he could. It's an hour flight.
Wants to.
You know what
he
I mean?
He could just come watch it.
Yeah. He could watch it with us.
Yeah. He's too busy doing comedy, I think.
Bastard.
Son of a bitch.
He'll come here one day.
Going to UFC is fun, though. When I went with Burdick that time, we had those seats that were right where the ring entrance was. It was amazing.
So much pay-per-view time
for
you.
It was so much fun. Oh, we were having a fucking blast. It was great. We were like little kids. I'm like, we sit down because we thought we had ringside. And we sit down. I'm like, this kind of sucks. We're not like... not that close to the ring, but it's not bad, you know. And the tickets were free, but they were like, you know, $400 tickets or something. Yeah. We're like, why are they so expensive? You know, I don't understand. And we sit down, and it was a really good fight. It's like Lyoto Machida and Chris Weidman. So this was actually one of the best fights in UFC history. Those two guys killed each other that night. But we sit down and we're trying to figure out, and we kind of look around, and then me and Burdick, like, it hits us at the same time. We're like, this is where the fighters are going to come out. We got excited, and we started standing up, and then we saw the security guys coming out, kind of clearing a path for them.
Yeah, that's cool.
Like, this is amazing. We were so pumped.
The only thing I remember about that fight is seeing you.
Yeah, just kept...
Your Reebok shirt.
Yeah, my Reebok slingshot shirt. With Katie Hogan and Jesse just going crazy next to the Brazilian people who were going nuts the entire time. They went fucking crazy the entire time because Lyoto Machida was fighting. They just went nuts, and they got the chant going the whole time and everything. But going to the new arena for wrestling was pretty cool. That the crowd was way into it. Which I've been to wrestling before at Arco, and it sucked. The crowd wasn't nearly as lively, and there wasn't nearly as many people. I think people are excited about the new arena.
Yeah, I think so too. Part of the way that they...
they're probably getting more noise.
They engineered it so that it reflects the sounds. Mm-hmm. Because for like before, people could stomp on and it was wood.
Yeah.
And this is all concrete, so that's not going to work. Mm-hmm. But obviously, it was at one point the loudest arena.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. So, I think for like 3 years, we had like the Guinness record for loudest... sporting event on TV or something.
Yeah,
in terms of decibels.
So I know that they were trying to be sure that they didn't lose that.
Yeah, cowbells and shit were going nuts like
2001. Yeah, all the full season ticket holders.
Back when we were crushing Steve Nash and all those fools from Phoenix.
Really? All the full season ticket holders got cowbells this year.
Oh, really? That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. Sentimental. I like
it.
What the fuck else we got going on?
Lifting weights.
We got some BB.com people coming in next week.
Yeah. We're going to podcast our faces off next week.
Who's coming in?
Everybody. You name it.
Blaine what? Sumner.
Yeah, Blaine Sumner.
Oh, Blaine Sumner. We have Blaine Sumner coming in.
Isn't he from the South?
He's from Texas.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's from Texas.
With an Australian.
It's just funny because last year when he was competing at IPF Worlds, they kept announcing him that way, like all proper and everything, and he'd come out like a maniac.
Yeah. He's got chalk on his face.
And he looked like the fucking Ultimate Warrior. His face is all painted up. That guy's nuts, man. I can't wait to interview him. That's going
to
be cool.
Yeah, it'll be cool to see him
fucking
lift.
Strong.
It'll be cool to see him lift in person. He might be maybe the strongest guy I've seen lift in person. I mean, I know we've had Spoto here and stuff, but like he's ridiculous.
Absolutely one of the best super heavyweights in the world.
And squatted same workout, 1060 in single ply and then 950 raw or something stupid like that. Yeah. Same workout? What the hell?
And then like a day or two later, bench 915 or something?
Yeah, I think all self handouts.
Yeah.
He never has a spotter or a liftoff guy for 900 pound benches.
I think on the bench he had some side spotters, but nobody helped him with anything.
No, he doesn't care.
Yeah, he's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I don't know. I wonder why he, it would be cool if he went head-to-head with Ray Williams. I don't know if they've ever done
that. They did. Ray
at an Arnold
got
or something?
The better of him because... Blaine, we can bring it up on the podcast.
Blaine, he was doing some...
Blaine missed a deadlift, I think, at the end.
I don't think either of them are known for their deadlift, but Blaine was doing some...
I think they competed together. Yeah,
At the Arnold, maybe. Because there was a year, 2 years ago, that Blaine did like...
He did regular raw shit, yeah.
He did like a full raw meet, raw bench only, and in a shirt bench only in the same weekend.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I think it was 2 years ago. But he was doing just to the knee deadlifts, like working off speed off the floor. And he takes 900. I think I don't know what his best pull is. You know, once again, here's my 50% fact. 760 or something. It's nothing insane.
He's
strong.
He's pulled around 800 pounds.
Yeah. It's like high sevens, low eights.
Yeah.
And he takes 900 and crushes it to his knee and then stops. And then you read the caption, like, that's what he was trying to do. I'm like, dude, it looked like he could pull 1,000. It's stiff bar. It's sumo.
Yeah.
It was insane. Single ply super. Who gives a shit?
Kind of has that old school strength, it seems like. You know, for whatever reason, he kind of seems like he is of that, like, Kazmaier type, just
era,
like fucking burly motherfucker who's crazy strong. Yeah, I always see pictures of him, like, fishing. He's got these giant-ass fish and, like, seems like he likes to, like, hunt and just hang out and...
Probably drinks
some
a lot of beer.
Kick some ass, yeah.
More beer.
Yeah, he does. He does look like he drinks. He does look like he drinks his fair amount of beer for sure. What the fuck else is going on? Me and Silent Mike did some squats yesterday. Some benching together.
We got some more squats tomorrow.
Oh my god! Every day
squatting every day. Turn into
squatting
Bulgarian.
Three times a week.
Trying
4 times a week.
Not yet.
What about our boy Little Smokey blasting up, 370 for doubles yesterday?
Yeah. He's going to bench like 430.
God damn, I hope so. Yeah. Slingshot. Yeah. I hope he benches something.
Yeah, 430.
Marcus blasting up 475 like it's nothing.
You trying to kill Damon?
We tried to sabotage Damon. It didn't work.
He's too good. I don't understand.
Yeah. I tried, buddy. I'm sorry.
I thought it was going to cut him in half, but then he pressed it.
Yeah, I didn't know. I didn't know what was going on. I was like, oh, make sure the next one you pause it.
And then I thought he would just do it. Yeah, yeah.
He's like, okay, Mark's going to give me a pause. And he gets off the bench and he's just like, what the fuck, Mark? Where's my command? And Mark's like, I never said I was going to give you command.
Yeah, he was down there for a long time.
Miscommunication.
That was probably the longest or the heaviest bench he's ever paused, yeah?
Yeah. Oh, he paused it forever, too.
Pause, no, but just like.
Oh, it is.
Because he's benched 500, but it was like.
He was 495.
Bouncy in the gym or whatever, yeah.
He had 473 in competition.
Mm-hmm.
So, I didn't know that.
Yeah, that was a really clean press. But yeah, I did try to sabotage.
But he doesn't squat or deadlift, so moving on to the next guy.
You guys have a bet.
We have a bet.
Yeah. A bench off bet?
Yeah. And the since I'm doing full power, that's my handicap.
Oh, that's
his
fair.
Handicap for a weight.
Yeah, because he weighs. Well, he looks so fat.
He's fat. He's fat.
He looks so fat.
I mean, they're not the same weight class, but he's definitely fat as well.
Well, he's only 80 pounds less than me right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
80?
About.
Yeah.
Maybe 79.
Boy right now.
Yeah.
You think about some of those lighter guys that are real short and stocky and they try to pull the weight class thing and you're like, you're pretty squatty, man. I don't think you should be using the weight class card right
now. I wonder if Wilkes or whatever fucking formula.
No.
If they could.
Oh.
You start to add in height, weight ratios, right? Like a 5'6", 200-pound guy is the same as a 5'8", 220 guy. They have like the same advantages.
I feel like they should be able to put you in a fucking DEXA scanner and measure all
body
of your
fat score,
all of your shit. Distances, you know, all of your leverages and all that shit, and come up with your coefficient.
Like if you're strong for how shit your leverages are.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, or opposite. Exactly. Like I have like pretty decent bench leverages, but I'm not that great of a bencher.
Yeah, so
you'd be
in the hole.
Yeah,
I think all those formulas came from Olympic lifting, I think.
I know they use what's called Sinclair, which is similar, but I don't know the exact formula of any of it.
Yeah.
Where's
yeah.
Robot when you need him?
I don't know.
We need a mathematical PhD.
Mr. Robot Pants?
Yeah.
He's working on robots. Appliances and shit.
He's working on robots.
Is he working that built appliances?
You pulled up a robot. What was that about?
Oh, yeah. This is
a
crazy
robot doing
thing.
Cock pushups.
It's... They built this robot that can do all kinds of things.
That's like a real robot.
It's a real robot. But the issue with it is that they heat up, and they have to figure out how to cool them down. And this one, they basically built the ability to sweat into
what it. What the fuck?
So they can cool down.
So it can cool down.
A mister starts fucking throwing
They're
it.
Trying to build a human.
It starts misting his parts.
Yeah.
His robot
Skynet's going to get fully realized.
Basically, yeah.
That's pretty scary.
Well, I never really thought about that before. Like a gaming computer is like water cooled because the processors get so hot
like
and stuff.
Yeah, your engine has an intercooler.
Needs a radiator.
That's pretty scary.
Yeah, I thought that was just fucking amazing.
Why is it doing push-ups? Just because they were trying to
show like heating up activity?
It's cheating.
I'm sure that
Kangaroo?
I'm sure that this one can walk too.
Kangaroo is a bio-inspired humanoid robot.
Oh no! Oh. It looks like Thomas the Train.
He does have a Thomas face, doesn't he?
He's pretty scary. Why has he got a rib cage? Why is this guy beating him up with a pad?
I don't know.
Is it a ninja robot?
100 motors.
Dude, that's pretty scary. I don't really like that.
Yeah, is anyone allowed to build that?
I think so. I don't think there's a law. If we knew how.
Shouldn't be.
I don't think there is... But there are certain kinds of technology that you can't export out of the United States to certain countries.
What is this? God damn, that's scary.
Fucking sucks at push-ups.
He can't bench shit.
He's a slingshot.
He's a little slow. Shit. He can't get all the way down there. I think his leverage is
without overheating. It looks like he's exhausted.
Yeah,
he's
look at his toes
head down.
And stuff. That's scary.
It probably is like crazy strong, though. You probably push a button.
He doesn't have any range of motion through.
Yeah.
Through his elbows. I think that's why he can't get down.
Internal rotation is fucked.
He's Kelly Starrett.
Yeah. Well, the other thing that's on our list but we didn't talk about is the baseball playoffs. And all I'm going to say is even though the Cubs beat my Giants, the Dodgers are playing the Cubs, and so the Cubs got to go all the way.
I know none of it.
It's been since
the Cubs
1908 that the Cubs were in the World Series.
Mm. That's pretty long.
Well, we can't have the Dodgers going to World Series anyways. It can't happen. Fuck the Dodgers.
That's a long time. But the Bears have won a Super Bowl since, yeah?
The Bears.
And obviously the Bulls in the 90s.
No. Oh, and since...
Yeah. I'm just saying, like no one has it like Cleveland.
Yeah.
Yeah, Cleveland's like the 50s, right?
Yeah, and it was every single team.
Yeah.
Not just one team that sucked. Every single team sucked.
Hmm.
LeBron's left.
Yeah, they left.
Yeah, and then won a Super Bowl.
God damn. Yeah, they haven't won since the old Cleveland.
They probably haven't won a Jim game Brown. Since.
That's a long ass time.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Jim Brown was pretty awesome, though.
But the Cavs won, though.
That's all that matters. We'll probably repeat.
Bron.
I doubt that. They're not going to repeat.
I think so.
You didn't even take the bet last year.
I think I did.
No, with me and you didn't take the bet.
I had a lot of confidence.
You guys have a fantasy thing going on?
Yeah.
Fantasy league now, yeah. Too.
Fantasy
and then fantasy football.
Yeah. Right. A lot of football fantasies.
Hmm.
You just switch a couple words out in this English language and it totally changes exactly. From fantasy football to football fantasies.
Yeah, which is totally different.
Right? 100% different.
God damn. Who's winning that?
Damon. Super Training League, Mr. Thurman.
Damon's kicking the shit out of everybody.
Yeah.
He drafted the three best running backs in the NFL.
Yeah, so. Mr. Thurman's winning.
We're all just getting kind of
smoked. It's still early. I'm not worried. I have a lot of confidence.
He's a couple injuries away.
Yeah. Who also gets hurt the most? Fucking running back. He's gonna get fucked up.
So we got a bunch of chicks coming.
Yeah, like 20 of them.
What's gonna happen?
And then like a million people from bodybuilding.com.
We're all gonna get divorced.
And then a million people from the public. Things are gonna get really wild in here. A
million people from the public?
Yeah, we're gonna.
I don't want to get divorced.
I don't.
All these hot chicks coming in here. Something
just
bad's
deadlifting
happen.
And squatting.
Yeah.
God damn. Know. Blaine Sumner's gonna randomly stick around, even though he's this is flight.
Yeah. We got Meg Squats coming, too.
Miss Squats. I think she competes today. I think she was in that flight going
She'll
on.
Be here like Wednesday, I think.
Meg got, Squats going to be hanging out.
Got the ever-so-fat Blaine Sumner coming on Monday. And got Meg Squats coming on Wednesday.
Very similar
and
builds.
And then a bunch of hot chiquitas on the weekend.
Friday. They're all coming to lift some heavy
who the
ass
hell
weights.
Is, who the hell is it all? It's Meg Squats.
Miss Amanda Bucci.
I think I follow that girl.
Amanda Bucci. You probably follow all these girls, Filipino
imagine,
Thunder.
I imagine that you do.
Yeah, it's right up your your alley.
And you're not even talking about Instagram. That's the problem.
Just randomly following
her all over the place.
What's that red stalking. Tape on those bars?
Oh, that's a good question.
It's on all of them. It's not in the middle.
It's not in the middle.
It really confuses.
It's on the one of the smooths.
It could be some sort of...
It's on all of them, though.
Designate one platform.
I don't know. No, yes. It's under people at training.
It could be somebody's bar. Like, these are my bars. I want them back.
I've seen them on Instagram on different people's Alico training bars.
I don't know. It's might weird. Not be tape then.
Yeah. It might be paint. I don't know. But it's something.
Maybe it's just to identify that it's
a fancy bar.
Specifically for this event, maybe.
Who knows?
I've seen it everywhere. All these people pulling sumo.
Yeah, it does look weird. Yeah, everybody's cheating.
Cheating.
All right, well, I think that's all the time we got for today. Multiply your hustle, multiply your muscle, and may all your shits be tapered. Assholes.
Shout out to everyone that supports us. Support those that support us. 8-Man Strong Apparel at 8manstrong.com. Bodybuilding.com for all your supplement needs. Increase your bench press at howmuchbench.net. Power of the Only Strength magazine in digital and print at thepowermagazine.com. I'm Silent Mike, Instagram, Twitter. YouTube, everywhere.
I'm Jim McD, STTV. Everywhere that I want you to find me, follow the show on Instagram. We are at Mark Bell's PowerCast. And we're out. Mark Bell's PowerCast is a production of supertraining.tv.